What's up, guys? Mike here, the Detroit Borg, and today we're taking a look at Google Wi-Fi. So this is a Google designed and Google made wireless router. It's available in the 1-pack and the 3-pack. Now, why would you want 3 routers? Well, this is actually part of a mesh networking solution for your home. Instead of buying just one router that is designed to reach across your home and then sort of patch it together with range extenders, instead you get a system specifically designed to create a mesh network that covers your entire house with a reliable and fast network. And this is a great solution, especially for me, because I have a fairly large house with dozens of devices connected to my router. So obviously the 1-pack won't take advantage of the mesh networking, but if you need to, you can buy another one later and expand it out to fill up your house. Now, last year I reviewed one of Google's partner products called the OnHub router that was made by TP-Link. Now, this will actually work with that. So if you want to extend the range of your existing OnHub router, this is designed to work seamlessly with that product as well. Now, I keep calling these routers, but they're really referred to as Wi-Fi points because they're part of a full network of devices. Now, Google recommends one Wi-Fi point for houses up to 1,500 square foot, and if you're between 1,500 to 3,000, you might want to buy two of them. But if you have a large home around 3,000 to 4,500, you want to go with the 3-pack, which is a better value overall. So getting to the unboxing, first thing we have to do here is remove the sleeve. The next thing we want to do is peel a piece of tape so we can open up the lid. Once we do that, the first thing we'll see here are the 3 routers. Now, the first thing to know is that all of these are identical. They have the same capability, so it doesn't matter which one is the main router and the others are the satellite routers. So what I mean by main router is that one of these have to be plugged into your ISP. So if I lift up one of these underside, you'll see all of our ports. So you'll find a USB Type-C connector for powering this, and I'll get to that in just a moment. And then we have a LAN and WAN port. So one of them connects to your ISP, and if you need to use it, you can connect a hardline connection if you want, but of course you only have one here. So getting the 3 routers out of the way, let's get to the accessories in the bottom of the box. So all we have to do is remove the tray. The first thing we'll see here is a single piece of paper explaining how to set this up for the first time, and it's pretty basic and we'll walk you through that. Next up, we have the accessories, and in the center compartment, we'll find a power adapter and an Ethernet cable. You'll only find one Ethernet cable in the entire box. So we get a 15-watt USB Type-C power adapter, which is nice and compact. So we have this external power supply that's not too bulky. Now, getting to the other accessory boxes, they just contain a power adapter for each of the other units. So these routers are extremely compact and lightweight. So they have some height for the antennas, but they're not too tall like you get with something like the AirPort Extreme from Apple. I actually think they're pretty nice looking. So when they're powered on, you get an LED light that sort of wraps around the edges. It's a soft white LED light, and it does change color depending on the network conditions or the configuration status of the router. Now, the LED light doesn't completely wrap around, and you can turn this off under settings if you don't want it on. So in addition to mesh Wi-Fi, it has pretty standard specs for consumer Wi-Fi. We have AC 1200 supported with 2x2 Wave 2 Wi-Fi. So this does support dual band 802.11 AC Wi-Fi for 2.4 and 5 GHz Wi-Fi. This also supports TX beamforming, so this will direct the Wi-Fi signal toward the device that needs it. This is also Bluetooth smart ready for those devices that can take advantage of it. Now, powering each of these routers is a quad-core processor with 512 megs of DDR3L RAM with 4 gigs of eMMC flash storage on board. So the first thing I want to do here is grab one of the routers, connect my ISP and the power, and get it booted up for the first time. Now, the next thing you'll need is the Google Wi-Fi app, which is available in iOS or Android. So you'll need one of those devices to set this up for the first time. Now, in my case, because I already had the app installed, it automatically sees the new hardware on the network and prompts me to set it up for the first time. So next up, the app is gonna prompt me to scan the QR code on the back of the device, or I can just type it in if I want. So once that's done, the phone can securely connect to the router so we can set it up and name it. So the first thing I'm gonna do here is name it Office, because that's where the main base will be housed. Next up, we need to name our Wi-Fi network and give it a password. And in my case, I'm just reusing my existing name and password so that all the devices that worked on the previous hardware will work on the new hardware without having to re-log in. Now, adding the other Wi-Fi points is very simple. It prompts me automatically to pick how many I need to still add and talks me through the process. And I don't need the devices near me in order to do that. So I can go ahead and place them in other parts of the house and set them up remotely. The only thing I need to do is label their location. And once those Wi-Fi access points are found, it establishes the network and we're ready to start using it. Now, once our network is set up, we can use our Google Wi-Fi app to manage the network and to use its many features. We can also see a complete overview of our network configuration and its health. So for example, we can go up to internet to see our speed. So if you want to test out our network speeds, we can do so right from the app. We can also see our usage. Unfortunately, this only works when you're actually looking at the usage. It's not constantly recording it in the background. Next up, we can see our three Wi-Fi points. So in my case, you can see the primary point is in my office, and we also have the bedroom and family room. And I can go ahead and test the mesh network integrity. So I can see how healthy that network setup is and if I need to move them closer to each other or add additional Wi-Fi points. So in my case, although not perfect, my network looks pretty strong. There's a few other things under Wi-Fi points to take a look at. So if you go to settings, you'll see your current software, so you can update that. We also can restart the network, which is very handy, and we have factory reset if we need to restore everything back to factory conditions. We also have our device settings. So if you click on one of them, you can change the LED brightness or turn it off. You can also restart that specific router. You can also factory reset that specific device instead of all of them. Next up, we can also take a look at all of the devices currently on our network, which is very handy to have. So you can see all of the devices currently connected and whatever is pulling the most data will be toward the top. So if I go ahead and click on one of them, I can see the usage information. So again, I can see the download and the upload rate. And if I go to details, I can rename the device if I want. I can also see which Wi-Fi point that one is connected to. I can see the IP address, MAC address. I can see whether it's using the 5 gigahertz or 2.4 gigahertz network and the type of device it is. Now there's another tab along the right that brings us to many features and settings we can take a look at, such as network check. So network check allows us to test our internet speed and the mesh strength, and you can also test the device's Wi-Fi speed. So if you're in other parts of the network and you want to test the Wi-Fi strength, this is a great place to go. So if you want to find those weak spots in your network, this is the utility you might use to find them. You can also select a priority device. So if you have a device on your network that you want to give the most bandwidth to, you can select that specific device. So for example, if I want my iMac to have the most bandwidth so I can upload this video, I can go ahead and select that. Now this is limited to 1, 2, or 4 hours, so you can't set this permanently. Under network settings, we do have our advanced networking for things like our DNS, WAN, as well as UPnP, DHCP IP reservations, as well as port forwarding. So you can lock your IP, establish port forwards, and much more. You can also add additional managers to this network so they can modify the settings and view the activity on the network. But what they can't do is factory reset it or add additional Wi-Fi points. We can also easily set up a guest Wi-Fi network here. So you can name the network, you can give it its own password. This allows you to sandbox those users from your main network or having access to a sensitive password. And you can give them authorization to access certain devices on your network. So if you want them to have access to your Chromecast, you can enable that under settings so that they can share their music and videos without having to log into your network. Family Wi-Fi is an interesting feature that basically allows you to pause internet access for certain devices. So for example, you can create a label for one of the kids in the family and then add their devices to this label. So that means when you click pause, this will pause internet access only for those devices. Now you don't have to create these labels to pause. You can do this manually just by going through the list of Wi-Fi devices on your network. And if you want this to automatically kick off, you can specify an end time. Another really interesting feature is called home control. So this allows users who are logged into our Wi-Fi network to go to on.here on their web browser to control home automation devices. In my case, those are Philips Hue lights. Now, if I don't want people to have access to this or control them, I can remove this under the app settings. But basically, this gives me a web interface that only people logged into my Wi-Fi network have access to. So they can turn on specific lights, change the brightness, or even the color. So I've been using Google Wi-Fi for about a week in my house, and it's been a big improvement over my previous system, which was a combination of a time capsule which had been range extended with an Airport Extreme and a Express. For some reason, that network became very unreliable. I had to constantly restart it because devices would lose their connection or they would slow down. I think this had something to do with the handoff between the different zones created by the range extended network, which isn't a true mesh network. And with the Google Wi-Fi system, it's much more adaptable. It's able to change the Wi-Fi channel for each device on the network depending on the network conditions. And the Google Wi-Fi system offers much more software management options that are simply not available with the airport utilities. So generally speaking, this is a fantastic system and I highly recommend it for its ease of installation, its great software features that are much better than the comparable Apple experience, and it's highly scalable for any situation. All right guys, hope you enjoyed this look at Google Wi-Fi. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up to let me know, and I'll see you again in the next video.